Goed, as ons gou die papier kan kry, ek gaan gou vir julle wys en dan gaan ons stap vir stap daarna kyk met die skyfies. Kan ons gou hierdie fokus op ons wit papier. Remember we've said the hypothesis or the pituitary gland secretes FSH, follicle stimulating hormone, which will act on the ovary to start developing a follicle. There's also a little LH secreted, adding to the development of the follicle. Die follicle, soos wat hy ontwikkel, skei estrogen af, estrogen secreted by the developing follicle. The function of estrogen is to act on the uterine lining, the endometrium, to make it thicker and thicker and thicker. Nou, net voor ovulasie, gaan die estrogen vlakke effens begin daal. So just before ovulation, estrogen will start to decrease. That decrease will stimulate LH to be secreted. En dan wanneer LH meer word, veroorsaak dit ovulasie. When ovulation occurs, it also means that there is no more estrogen. As die estrogen vlakke daal, dan stop FSH ook. En LH is nou 'n piek. LH bereik 'n piek met ovulasie. Ons gaan net nou vir julle wys. Is julle nog by? So we've got FSH that will stimulate follicle production, the follicle that will stimulate estrogen that will cause the uterine lining to thicken. When estrogen drops, FSH will stop, more LH and ovulation will occur. LH se tweede funksie. Ja, Karen, jy gaan
net voordat jy na LH se tweede funksie toe gaan. Ek wonder of ons leerders weet wanneer net voor ovulasie, wanneer estrogen eintlik veroorsaak dat daar minder FSH afgeskei word. Hoekom gebeur dit?
Ja.
Want waarvoor staan FSH? What does it stand for? It stands for follicle stimulating hormone, which means that if there's no more FSH, another follicle won't be able to start developing.
Yes, we're focusing on this one follicle now.
Yeah.
Right, so let's continue. Goed. Met ander woorde, FSH is nou geinhibeer. LH het nou ovulasie veroorsaak. Now, this egg cell can now either be fertilized or not. We will get back to that just now. Die oorblijfsel van hierdie follicle, the remains of the follicle, will develop into what we call the corpus luteum. Nou, die tweede funksie van LH is om hierdie corpus luteum te stimuleer en aan die gang te hou. So, LH has two main important functions. Number one, to stimulate, that's the main functions, to stimulate or to cause ovulation. And number two, to maintain the corpus luteum. Why is that important? Because the corpus luteum will now produce the second important hormone. Want daar estrogen het mos nou gestop. So daar moet 'n tweede hormoon wees wat verantwoordelik is vir die ontwikkeling van die uterus. En daardie hormoon is progesteroon. So now the progesterone levels will increase. As the progesterone levels increase, the endometrium will thicken until it is time for either menstruation or the continuation of a pregnancy. Right. If there is no pregnancy, in other words, no fertilization of this egg cell, the progesterone levels will drop. Saam daarmee, nou estrogen is intussen 'n klein bietjie afgeskei, maar estrogen vlakke val. If these two levels drop, it is a stimulus for the endometrium to be shed as menstrual blood. Wanneer dit gebeur, gaan die hypofise weer begin om FSH af te skei vir die volgende siklus. Interessant genoeg is dat dit alternatief werk. In other words, you have alternating 1 month this ovary,
yes,
other month the next ovary, which means that it does take about 2 months for the complete development from the start to the end. Nou hierdie diagram wat ek hier gehad het, lyk baie die mekaar, en daarom gaan Karl en julle nou gou-gou stap vir stap deur die proses neem.
Ja, en ek hoop julle het geluister wat Lorraine sê, dat het altyd die een hormoon is wat of die ander hormoon stimuleer of inhibeer. En ek wonder of hulle nog kan onthou wat word daar die interaksie genoem waar die een hormoon of stimuleer of die ander een inhibeer. To inhibit or to stimulate the production of a hormone. I wonder, can you still remember that? The negative feedback mechanism.
So het ons iemand wat gevra dat ons dit sal verduidelik, wat ons pas gedoen het.
Nee, ons gaan definitief.
En ons gaan weer nou daarna kyk, hoor.
And here we have a beautiful diagram for all of you to, and I hope you understand this fully after we have completed this. And once again, we're going to give you a bonus. I will start off. If I do forget anything, Lorraine will not chip in, but she will just assist here
I'll
and help.
Chip in every year.
Exactly. And then she will also do this in Afrikaans for the Afrikaans learners, because this is a very important process.
Yes, and we also have this in line drawings later, so don't worry, just bear with Karlyn while she does it.
So what are we going to point out to you is, and we want you to see the brain here, and we focus here on the pituitary gland, because it's the pituitary gland that has to secrete the two hormones, FSH, LH. Remember what I said? Directly into the blood. And what do they do? Here you see, this is that the FSH is a little bit more than the LH. And what do they do? You see the following arrows? It goes down. They are directed at to stimulate the follicle to become mature. And as this follicle matures, it secretes estrogen. And here you see the estrogen levels increase. The progesterone levels remain unchanged. And the estrogen, what do they do? You will see here that they are supposed to form a new uterus or uterine lining. Let's start all over again. Just the one phase. We look at the first phase, it's the follicular phase or the menstrual cycle. There you see, first of all, the pituitary gland, it secretes a lot of FSH, more FSH, then LH. What are they supposed to do? They are responsible for the growth of the follicle. And as the follicle develops, they secrete estrogen. And the estrogen, you can see the levels increase here. What is the estrogen supposed to do? It is supposed to thicken or to form a new, this is menstruation. So after menstruation, a new uterine lining must be formed. And when that is ready, you will see just before, this line here is on day 14. And remember what Lorraine said, it might not be always on day 14, but let's keep it at day 14 here. And just before day 14, the estrogen level drops. But as the estrogen level drops, all of a sudden, LH, sky high, a lot of LH is secreted and also FSH. And those two hormones, they cause this process to take place. And this is ovulation. Right. So then you will see that the progesterone, after ovulation, all of a sudden, this graafian follicle becomes a corpus luteum. You remember what Lorraine said? Becomes a corpus luteum. And the corpus luteum, it secretes progesterone as well as a little estrogen. And those two hormones together, they have to maintain, and you will see that this uterine lining becomes more vascular as well. They become thicker and more vascular. And you know why? So when this egg cell here will be fertilized to accept it to be implanted. And you will see this whole section here is happening in the ovary. This is an indication here of the lining of the uterine wall. This section here is the brain. So, three different sections in one graph. Now, if you look at this graph, how do you read this? Here you see all of a sudden there's a drop of progesterone as well as estrogen. But there's also, you will see that the uterine lining is also declining. There's a decrease in the thickness of it. Why? That means that fertilization of this egg cell has not taken place. And because of the corpus luteum that degenerates, it breaks down, that is why the progesterone levels and the estrogen levels will drop. And this will cause menstruation all over again. And I hope that will be clear enough for you.
Ja, dit is nogal 'n ingewikkelde proses wat ons nou hier verduidelik het. Is er julle paar navrae oor hoekom die ovulasie dan nou nie op dag 14 is nie? Mense verskil. Soos wat ons verskillend lyk, ons verskillende talente het, verskil vrouens se siklusse ook. You will always see that we talk about day 1 to day 28 cycle. For some women it's longer, for some women it's shorter. That is the average. Colin has mentioned in the beginning that menstruation in most of the pictures that you get in diagrams will be day 1 to 4. For some women it's day 1 to 10 even. For some women it's a 2-day period. So it differs. But we just want to let you know, and you must know that ovulation is not restricted to day 14. And we will get to that again later. It is important because some people want to use that, the date of ovulation, as a method of contraceptive. It does not work. Right.
And to this learner that just in capital letters, that said, please, that teacher that speaks English, will she please speak Afrikaans? If you have listened, my dear, I said that the same process will be now explained in Afrikaans by Lorraine.